Hello, it's Doug Sharples here, and I want to welcome you into our next flight in FS Economy. This is going to be flight number 28. We're currently in the Solomon Islands, so we've made our way up from New Zealand, and we're currently based at Honaira International Airport. Now, where we're going to be going today is to Auki Airport. And we're going to be taking two Solomon Air passengers, the 57 nautical miles. So I've just been into my FS Economy and I've rented my own aircraft. As you know, I own a Cessna 172. And I looked and it was prohibited from making flights. So what I have had to do, find it, is I've had to do essential repairs. And those repairs have cost me $2,858. I'm quite lucky that there was a maintenance shed here at Henderson Airfield, so I could get these essential repairs done. As you can see, this is the receipt for it. So we're going to be taking a direct flight. There's going to be no point in checking on little nav map the route, because it's only a short flight. The weather's going to be historical detail from yesterday. So all the weather conditions are going to be incorrect this morning time. What we'll do is we'll jump into the cockpit. I'll welcome you on board and we'll get on our way for this short flight into Auki Airport. I want to welcome you all to the cockpit. I've currently done all my checks, set my altimeter for 5,000 feet, and that's the cruise height. Everything's already set up. It's 7:34 a.m. and it's 80 degrees outside. This historical weather. So I'll shut the door, turn the engines on. Tune to the radio frequency and we'll request IFR clearance. We'll acknowledge the IFR clearance. We're going to be taking off at runway 6. With it being an IFR flight, I'll wait until I receive instructions on to which runway I'm going to land on. But we'll select runway 6 to take off. We'll set our heading knob for that, which is 59 degrees. And we'll announce that we're taxiing to the runway. Release our parking brake. Push back. It's only a short taxi to the runway. We'll just push back for a little while and then we'll be going on taxiway Alpha. When we reach the runway, we will turn right for a short while, turn ourselves back round, head in the right direction. Stop our pushback here. We'll add a little bit of power to get us moving. Taking off on flap setting 1. Unfortunately today, ladies and gentlemen, the only snacks we have on board are a packet of stale crisp and some pop that's been opened and it's gone flat. So nothing much in way of snacks, thanks. But if you do get peckish and you rummage around the back of your seats, I'm sure there's some stale crust there, an old mouldy sandwich. Don't think there's anything coming in. Turn around here, line ourselves up on the runway, at the centre of the runway. Get our clearance to take off. DC departing to the
Alpha
east.
Golf, Golf Hotel traffic, Solar 2-8, taking off runway 6, departure to the east.
Now what? It's the parking brakes. Keep it straight with a bit of rudder. 60 knots, take off. Positive climb. Flaps up. Now we're bearing for 32 degrees. Nice picturesque views. Here we are over the sea. Like I say, it's all your short flights, 57 miles, it takes us about half an hour. Currently two runways at Auki, that's runway 18 and runway 36. Not an asphalt runway, it's a coral runway, which like sand. But I'm not used to landing on sand runways. But we'll see how we go.
1100, soar 28.
Quite difficult to descend to 4100, being as we're cruising at 4100. But at least we've got some instructions from air traffic control. They took the time. Landed on runway 18, which is on a heading of 179. Coming onto the coastline of this island of Malaita. Maita. Not like 14 miles away from the airport. Not a lot to see because there's low cloud. Big old just over the course line.
Turn right heading
150. 428.
Turn right heading 150.
428. We'll need to start descending again soon to get under this cloud. We can see what the horizon's like. They've not given me instructions to descend, so I guess I'm going to have to descend myself. Knock it down to 2,000. Because I'm only 6 minutes away. Continue with what ATC are going to tell us. Back up to 4,100. With a very steep descent. Got a feeling, ladies and gentlemen, that we're gonna have to go around. because we are 7 minutes away from the airport, really 7 miles away. And we haven't been told to descend any decent. Can't see the airport. The wall cloud cover. Tells me to descend now.
Descend and maintain 2500. Soar 28.
Even so, with the runway at an altitude of 29 feet, it's not going to give me a lot of time to get this plane down. Runway's still not in sight. This is quite a dark one. Have the runway in sight now. Gonna drop that far in 2 minutes. So, gonna report missed approach.
So
we'll turn left heading 4. I'm not going to climb to 4,300, I'm going to continue at 2,000 feet. In fact, we will do what ATC say.
Soar 28, please expedite your climb to 4,300.
We'll go to 4,300. This is what I mean about default ATC. 2 miles out and they expect me to drop 2,000 feet in 2 miles. It's, yeah. I think I need to invest in ATC Pro. Go override the default because the default is absolutely useless. Should really fly these short hops, BFR. They have enough fuel on board for another hour and 45 minutes. Turn left. V60. And we will climb and maintain 4,300.
Turn left, heading 360. Climb and maintain 4,300. Soar 28.
Right, heading 025, that's 428.
Turn right, heading 025, soar 28.
Thank you. turn left, heading 265, saw 28. Heading 210, saw 28.
Sure, 28. Did you hear my last transmission?
Yes, I did. may just be a case that I cancel the IFR, which is what I am going to do.
On the IROD center, Solar 2-8 would like to cancel IFR. Solar 2-8, understand cancel IFR, please confirm. Affirmative, cancel IFR, Solar 2-8. Solar 2-8, IFR flight plan is cancelled, radar service terminated, squawk 1200, maintain VFR, frequency change approved.
Just given my intentions to land. Plane's descending to 2,000 feet. Power down on the engines. Miles away, 5 minutes. The runway just ahead. Increase my descent to 1,000 feet a minute. I'm going to take over the plane now. I'm going to manually land this myself. I don't know if it'll messing about with me. Five miles away. Second notch of flaps on, close down a bit more so we can get down that little bit quicker. We're descending at around 1,000 feet a minute. We're back in on the path now. Only a short runway, so I've got to really for it. And at around 700 feet a minute. 1,000 feet. Get back up, 2 minutes away. The nose up. Keep adjusting, slight adjustments. No pappy light, so I don't know whether I'm on the deviation for it. According to the little nav map, 31 feet. 1 minute away, 1.4 miles. Last notch of flaps. Feet. The nose up a bit, up the climb. Just swallowed something, it's gone down the wrong hole. There we go. Excuse me. Bloody hell, I'm choking to death here. Laps up. Made it with plenty of room to spare. Come off here. One. Back up in bay one. Just here. Come to me. Apply parking brakes. Switch the engine off. You can unbuckle your seatbelts now. For some reason the door won't open. You can exit the airplane at your own leisure. Thank you for flying with Soar Airways. I'll go and join you in FSEconomy and we'll check out the financial status. I'll join you again in a moment's time. So here's the breakdown of this flight. The income was $1,197. I rented the aircraft for 1 hour 21. The ground crew fee was $119.70, which is 10%, which as per usual. So the earnings of this flight were $1,077.30. There's not that much cash though in the balance, as you can see, because I had to repair the aircraft, which took it out of my cash, which left me with a negative balance. So this has just broken me even. Again, I'm hope you're going to join me on the next flight, because we'll be travelling 134 nautical miles, Alpha Golf Golf Victor, which is So a Vaneo. Hopefully on the next flight there won't be any hitches and try get there in one swoop. Won't need to go around because I'm going to fly it VFR until we start receiving the instructions, and then I'm going to cancel the VFR and fly IFR and manually fly it in myself. I've had enough of default ATC messing me around. So join me next time. And if you like what you see, hit that subscribe button, hit the bell notifications, and give me a big thumbs up. It really does help my little channel out. And I'll join you next time. And that's me signing off for now. Happy flightings.